So the key messages that we have for the market today are that we remain very focused on our health and safety initiatives to ensure that our people, our customers, our tenants, and our shareholders are safe. The demand for L2D space remains strong. And given the quality of our assets and our focus on ensuring sustainable business operations, we've experienced an encouraging recovery in our trading environment, and we continue to implement effective capital and risk management plans to protect and preserve our balance sheet. Our net asset value was R7.62 at the end of June, and that is supported by independent valuations for our full portfolio that we undertake twice a year. And in our presentation later, Jose will unpack a little bit further of that. What is really important for us is that these half-year results be seen within the context of a first half of last year that were different than what we had. So we had very strong trading in the first 3 months of the year. Then we had the hard lockdown in the second 3 months of the year. This year, we've had various levels of lockdown, level 3 in the beginning of the year, level 4 now, and an encouraging recovery in the middle. But our hotels didn't trade. The convention center was closed. Many of the restaurants haven't resumed full trading. And it's important to look at our results that we are presenting today in that context. It will take time for things to recover to pre-COVID levels. And we continue to work towards making sure that we support our tenants in the best possible way, but that we create a business that is continuing to operate. I think one of the most important messages for me today in our results is that the occupancies in our malls have continued to improve, and our retail occupancy was 96.7% at the end of June. That is higher than our December occupancy. And if we add in the new lettings that was done, this occupancy increases to 97.1%. Now, a 3% vacancy in this environment is the best argument I can offer when I make the case for good quality and well-located super-regionals and regional malls. It's not a feeling. It's not a perception. It's not whether they are dead or alive. It's a simple fact that they are in demand. And I think that's a very important message that we have today. We've had great leasing activity over time. The retail reversions, I'm sure, will be of concern to the market, but they are better than what we had expected. And we do anticipate that they will still come through to the second half of the year, but we will continue to keep our tenants to enable to keep our space occupied and have that balance between those two things. Our turnover has recovered nicely, and we've seen encouraging signs of May 2021 being higher than May 2019 at a portfolio level. Now, we're not just talking about Sandton. And we're talking about a recovery across the board, and that is very pleasing for our business. It is then that we are very pleased that our board has resolved that they have a confidence in our business and the confidence in our strategy going forward to be able to declare a full payout of the interim distribution of 15.79 cents. The ongoing impact of COVID-19 coupled with the arrest that happened and the very many uncertainties that remain in the market, we've resolved not to provide earnings and distribution guidance, as this is too many moving parts and there's not enough certainty for us to be able to do so. However, we will continue to make sure that the safety, security, and well-being of all our people are looked after. And when I say people, I mean our L2D people, the people in our malls, the service providers that we have, and the people of our tenants, because without those, we can't have a successful business. Our assets remain resilient, and these results, I think, speak to that, and the demand for space continue to drive our performance. In times like this, we look after what we have in the best possible way. Our operational strategy is clear. It's focused on cost optimization, capital projects that we identified, creating alternative rental income streams, disposing of our non-core assets, and income protection in a sustainable manner. Our focus on our balance sheet will remain to preserve the balance sheet and to control costs, and to invest where we can make the biggest difference for our future growth. So we have a clear operational strategy, and we remain committed to executing our business in a sustainable manner and also remain adaptive as we rebuild for growth.